This morning in the kitchen, GoProvidence.com brings us Chef Joseph from, well, a lot of places. Hillside Bistro, La Collina, and Tiki Bar. You are making Thai peanut calamari.
Yeah, we're going to demonstrate and talk about just a little bit different way to make one of Rhode Island's favorite dishes, calamari.
Yeah, this is a classic. I've never even thought to put Thai peanut sauce with it, but take us through the ingredients that we need.
All right, so normally you'll just get some calamari, have it cut up into little 3/4-inch rings. Also, I prefer the tentacles with that as well, and then you'll flour it up. And then with some red peppers here, and then we'll fry that. And then when you take it out, you toss it in the Thai peanut sauce, and then we have an accompanying cilantro cream sauce with cilantro lime. Again, sticking with that Thai theme, and a nice Thai chili sriracha sauce.
And so does the Thai peanut sauce have any heat to it?
It has a little bit. It has a little bit of the Thai chili in it, but more of the savory flavor of salt and the peanuts as well in there. And then so this is to take it over the edge, and the lime cuts everything like that. Same thing with the cilantro cream, so it gives you a nice balance in there.
Yeah, very well balanced. You mentioned that the calamari, of course, will be fried. That's pretty typical.
Yeah.
The peppers are fried too?
Yeah, we put them all in there together so they're nice and crispy on the outside, and you're eating everything at once. And everything gets the sauce.
And because calamari is so thin, how long does it take to fry those?
It's only about 45 seconds. You'll actually hear it slow down in the while you're frying it. The bubbles will be going really fast, about 45 seconds to a minute. You'll hear them slow down. That's all the water coming out of everything, and that lets you know, hey, this is done. It's time to toss it.
I always like when the food tells you.
Oh,
when
I know.
It's right?
Anything helps, right?
It makes it a lot easier, and you're actually going to show us more about that cooking process in just a bit, right?
Absolutely.
Okay, plenty more when we come back. Now that we're going to head back into the kitchen, Will is getting ready to make that calamari.
That's right. Rolling up our sleeves for this one, thanks to GoProvidence.com. Chef Joseph is here. Hillside Bistro and Tiki Bar is part of this. We've got some calamari with a twist on the menu.
That's right. We offer it both ways as well. The typical Rhode Island style, we'll do it the same way. Taking the calamari and taking the peppers with the regular style, we'll use the peppercini, the banana peppers.
Right.
And we'll do a lemon basil aioli instead of a cilantro cream, and then we'll give you marinara sauce as well.
Okay.
And right here, we're just prepping the calamari. We got a nice hot fry later here. And we're dredging our calamari and our fire-roasted red peppers.
And you have that, what is that, a flour roll?
Yeah, it's a typical, actually, made in Warwick, a typical brand called Fish Chick.
All right.
A lot of people are familiar with that. Made by, I believe it's Drum Rock. But support your local Warwick company here. And that's all we do is dredge it, shake it off really, really well, and
then you have the fry later set at 350.
Yep. And these fry daddies are very good for home use.
Work great. I mean, I've used those before, and it's easy cleanup.
Yeah.
Simple and easy to use, even if for someone who's never, you know, never had to use anything like that before.
And they're relatively inexpensive.
Inexpensive to have to. You would tell Michaela before that the calamari itself is only going to have to be in there for maybe 40, 45 seconds before it crisps.
You can hear it. It's building up right now.
Right.
And then you'll hear it, and it'll slow down. And then that's when you know it's all the water has come out. And you want to stop it at that point, because what happens when all the water's out, that's when the oil wants to go back in.
Okay.
So that way you don't soak it, and that way it stays crispy too.
And you don't want it too greasy.
Correct.
Too greasy as well.
Yeah.
You also got some Brussels sprouts you were cooking this morning. We're going to talk about that and put those and show everybody those. And also, Hillside is a great place to be too. Great restaurants, great event place. Also,
We have banquets going on. You can go golfing. We have a spa. We have a pool.
We experienced that last year, and it was a great place. We'll talk about that in just a little bit. See what else is going on over there, and check out all the great things that he's making for us today. Back to you.
Well, you may have had calamari before, but I bet you've never had it like this. Thai peanut calamari is what we're making with Chef Joseph. Thanks so much to GoProvidence.com for bringing him in. You take care of a lot of places over at Hillside.
I do. We have a outdoor tiki bar, and we have La Collina restaurant right above the tiki bar. We service both the restaurant and the tiki bar right through our outdoor kitchen. We have a big Neapolitan oven out there for our pizzas, and you get to, it's something nice to see as well. You get to see the fire, it's ambiance. And you're overlooking the ninth green, so it's a beautiful spot.
Yeah, beautiful view and delicious food. So you fried up these calamari earlier.
Yes, I did. So we have the peppers in here. We fried them up, and we tossed them with our Thai peanut sauce. Mm-hmm. And underneath here, we've already put the cilantro cream. And this is our sriracha. And then that's all we do is pop it on there, garnish it with a little bit of scallions. And this is exactly how you'll see it at the Tiki Bar.
Beautiful. This must be so popular, too.
It is. It started off slow because you know how people resist change. And then a couple people got it, and then word of mouth gets around. And you know what? They really do enjoy it. We sell a lot of it now.
Yeah, you sell a lot of everything else. You've been very busy. Tell us what you have going on in the oven.
Well, we figured we'd introduce you to some of our winter dishes that are coming up. It's time, fall is coming up, even though, you know, it is hot outside.
Yeah.
It's still 80 degrees. But
a lot of those fall flavors will start to come into play.
That's right. And we are open year-round. Our hours will shorten Wednesday through Saturday during November and December.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll have a lighter fare plus entrees available for everyone to try.
And this is something that, like you said, that anyone can try. You don't have to be a member.
No, you don't. It's open to the public for everything. Golf, the pool, the Tiki Bar. We hold weddings there, banquets. You can rent out the restaurant if you'd like.
Wow.
So we're there for everybody.
You really are.
Huh?
You accommodate everyone.
We do. We try.
Now, this is a Roadshow favorite. Will and I... and others. We love Brussels sprouts. Did you fry these in the...
I did briefly, and then I threw them in the oven with some bacon. And then we have our friend here, Mr. Short Rib.
The smells coming from this kitchen are absolutely incredible. You have the Thai peanut sauce. You have those beautiful Brussels sprouts with the bacon. Now these ribs coming in.
Oh, yeah. This is a beautiful beef short rib, and we braise it for about 4 hours. And then we take it out. We bake it again in a little bit of the jus that came with it.
Mm-hmm.
And we have our little sweet potato, parsnip potato fall mash with a little bit of maple, organic maple Vermont syrup in there. And then we have our crispy Brussels sprouts with bacon.
I'm still on like the watermelon summer squash, corn on the cob kick. But you are making me want all these butternut squash and the Brussels sprouts.
It's going to be coming up. So this is a good balance between salty, sweet, savory, and then we just top it off with little crispy onion strings, and that's it.
I know you mentioned something like the calamari found at the Tiki Bar.
Mm-hmm.
Where can we find this entree?
This will be, we have one menu for the restaurant and the Tiki Bar.
Okay.
So either place you sit, you can order any of these things. When we do our new menu, it'll be first or second week in September. We'll also have our spinach salad, which is very popular in the summertime, but it also has the winter flavors. We have baby spinach, toasted almonds, red onions, craisins, and some crumbled gorgonzola, and then on top of that, we have our friend again. We have a warm bacon vinaigrette that goes on top of there.
A warm bacon vinaigrette?
Yeah, so we'll do bacon, four vinegars, a little bit of sugar, a little bit of apple juice. It goes on there, and people love that. That's a huge seller in the summertime as well.
I love everything. I think you sold. You sold the Roadshow crew. They're not going to last very long in this kitchen. But again, if you want to find them for yourselves, you can. Like you said, open to the public year-round. Stop on by, grab something nice to eat. Grab these recipes, too, over at roadshow.com.